What about virtual production? You know, I would love to talk with some experts from maybe Epic Games and, let's say, Amazon Studios about virtual production. Ah, David, Ken.
Hey.
Just the two people I needed to talk to. Great to see you. Great to see you. So I wanted to have a quick conversation about virtual production. So this seems to be a pretty big trend, but maybe before we start, Ken, virtual production. That means a lot of things to a lot of people right now. What does virtual production mean to you?
It's creating technologies that help filmmakers tell stories. So it's everything that has traditionally been done and enhancing all of those techniques to help us and help the filmmakers even be better at their jobs and make it an easier process and a more collaborative process.
Ooh, I love that. Where are some of the areas that, in particular, that's coming to life in productions right now?
A lot of it is remote collaboration. So along with the pandemic, it's been very difficult for people to gather together. So what this has done, virtual production has done, has given the ability for people to, wherever they are in the world, be able to meet and do the tasks that they normally do where they had to do it together. So for example, virtual location scouting. Before it was location scouting. You all had to get in a van. Well, first, all had to travel to a town. You have hotel, transpo, and then you had to go out to the locations in the van and drive from location to location. Now, you don't have to go anywhere but your living room. You have people that go out, small teams that go out and scout, bring the locations to the cloud, and then now we can all get together and jump into sessions and start pointing at the different locations that were captured.
Oh, I love that. So David, when we say the words virtual production, the next word that often rolls off our tongue is Epic Games, Unreal Engine.
Right.
So what is it that you're seeing with some of the customers of your product, and how are you seeing virtual production working right now in the industry?
Yep, virtual production, has been around for a while, and they're dating back to the days of Jim Cameron and Robert Zemeckis way back when they set the stage for doing this. But virtual production is really simple to understand when you see it as production using real-time tools, using real-time computer graphic tools. And as Ken was saying, it applies to anybody, essentially, doing a movie. Every department has a use for these virtual tools to supplement what they're doing in the real world in a way to be able to add to a real set, a virtual set, or to be able to add into previs a whole series of tests and the location scouting up all the way out to visual effects and finishing. You can use real-time tools, and that's what virtual production is.
I love that. So it's really in the whole life cycle, is what both of you have said. What are some of the specific tools, techniques that you found are really helpful, the ones that you're looking at right now?
For virtual production, I think that remote collaboration, like I said before, isn't just, I gave the example of virtual location scouting, but it's all the visualizations in between too. From the beginning of movie making, we use storyboards to kind of plan out our story. Now, then we've taken those storyboards, you know, with the advent of the computer, brought it in, started making animatics. Then it became pre-visualization to where we can now see characters and backgrounds and effects all come to life and be able to make real-time decisions, like David was talking about. But on top of that, now we can start tech-vising, which is just figuring out all the different elements that need to go into a shot. So breaking that out, making it easier to consume. So you can see that as we move forward, now we start getting into real time where the director can now get involved with it. It's constantly evolving where now the real time aspect of it is that you're not only making real time pre-visualization with actors in motion capture suits, you're also giving the director real time decision potential to be able to see it and make decisions and blocking decisions in real time. So this is huge in terms of the spark of creation is now given back to the filmmakers. And we look at every single filmmaker all the way down the line and look to see how to make their job better.
Oh, I love that. David, I bet you brought up the real time. I bet you're seeing that right now with some artists that you've been working with.
Yeah, absolutely. I think there was this phase of the motion picture and television industry where visual effects really grew for many years and showed the way of what you can put on screen now that doesn't exist, right? But at first, computers were slow, and it was all done in a back room, and you didn't see it when you were shooting it. Or even when you were planning in the beginning, you had no idea. So you had to be this sort of intellectual director, right? I'm sure
yes.
That you met many that had like Steven Spielberg, able to see it all in his head and then plan it and tell other people what to do. But it's not the average director. And now with the advance of technology and our tools coming up and the investment that we've been doing, you know, all along the way, there were steps of trying to be real time. You know, Jim Cameron on the first Avatar did the absolute best he could with the technology of the time to be real time. But it was expensive and it was custom and it was, you know, only a few could afford this. But now that's why we invested along the way, many of us working in different companies and now into real-time technology to bring that to bear and so that we can have a free tool essentially available for artists and being able to work this way. You know, and in their home, using, you know, basic computer hardware and in the cloud to be able to use technology that decouples your local hardware and that you can then start working together. And then, of course, we had the pandemic that nobody wanted or planned for, but that forced us to be more collaborative in a remote kind of way. And to be, we couldn't go to location as much, mm-hmm. right? We couldn't put people in planes, go anywhere. And so this, we were just kind of ready, not by any form of planning, but we had the tools ready so that people could collaborate and work together. And then, of course, with the power of the cloud and the Amazon tools, that now you can bring that collaboration together, and it's a new era.
Oh, I love that. Now, you mentioned that we've been doing some of this virtual production work for a while. But a lot of us started seeing this and became really popularized with The Mandalorian. What's changed here in just the last 5 years? What's different today?
The immediacy, the real time, was not even present before. So in the last 5 years, what we're seeing on set is, you know, with the frustum, being able to have the proper perspective matched to the practical camera in real time, that's the technology had to catch up with the desire to do so. So the freedom that filmmakers have right now has never been so freeing. Before, they were always shackled to their technology. They tried to shoot in certain ways and you'd get frame bumps. You couldn't keep up with, you'd get ripping, you know, different types of things that are happening in your background. Now it's all real time and there's ways around it. There's backup systems. And so it's a very more robust system. It's less R&D, it's more production. And like David said, it's now for the masses. So these technologies are now out that from indie all the way to AAA majors can get the software for free. And it's a very low barrier to entry.
Thank you, David, for that, by the way.
Yes,
that's a, it's not just me.
It's incredible software. Incredible
it's a
software.
Team.
Yeah, yeah. Well, thank you for the whole team, for
right.
sure. What do you, if you fast forwarded a year, SIGGRAPH 2022, mm-hmm. What would you see? What would you expect the audience to see between now and SIGGRAPH 2022?
It's hard to predict because we're in an adoption cycle, right? And so the tools are out there, but they're not too many people know how to use them yet. There's a lot of, it can be picked up, people can use them, but how to use them and how to insert them in your creative process, this is in the making right now. So in a year, I think we're going to see a lot more adoption, a lot more people using the tools in the cloud, and we're going to who knows what we're going to see creatively. It's a completely new phase.
Oh, it's pretty exciting. Wait, what do you think?
I agree completely, and I want to go further in the sense that up until this point, it's been the very technophilic, the directors and filmmakers that love technology that have gotten into the space. What we need to happen in the next year is the education, but also the ease, meaning that people who don't even know what virtual production is able to pick up a tool and intuitively understand how it works, because it's still filmmaking, and we want to make it accessible to people who aren't technical savvy people. They're just really good filmmakers who don't have the computer graphics experience or the game technology experience. They just have the film cinematic experience and can take those skill sets and use them, 30 years of cinematography, without having to deal with how a virtual camera works is very powerful to a lot of DPs. So, and then you just go down the call sheet. Everybody that can walk on a set and see what it looks like instead of walking to a sea of green, they walk into the actual location that's going to be shooting. That's huge, and bring that and the ease of the technology. The technology is there and getting better. the ease of it is still a little bit behind. It's still a little bit hard to get in terms of the learning curve. And I think that that's what we'll probably get in the next year.
I got it. So adoption phase, a lot more to learn. So it sounds like what we probably should continue to encourage is everybody is to, you know, get going with it. Yeah. This is the time. It sounds like it's accessible. And just the promise of that sounds amazing, to be able to walk into a space and just be able to experience what it would like to be there. All right. So David, Ken, virtual production, virtual scouting, LED panel walls. Is this going to become a thing?
I don't know. What do you think, Ken?
I think so.
You know, I think it's going to become a thing, too. Thank you guys very, very much for coming and being with us today.
Really
appreciate it. And thank you all for joining us today. And if you haven't figured it out by now, yes, we are, in fact, on an XR stage today. So first of all, great shout out to XR at 204. Really appreciate the lease of this wonderful facility, ICVR, with all of the great work that you're seeing behind me. Brendan Bennett Productions, thank you very much. The wonderful crew that we have here today. And lastly, I wanted to say thank you out to the SIGGRAPH conference. Everybody at SIGGRAPH 2021, have a great show.
Good day.
Action on.